new thing for all of you. You have already done such kind of question various time in your academics, in your classes, maybe in third, fourth, fifth, sixth classes. So the questions are just very simple, very easy. Few questions are based on Venn diagram. Some questions are based on a very general equation. Maybe if you want, you can solve the question with the help of options also. So let's initiate. Good afternoon, everybody. Here is the very first question. Let's do one thing, student. Let's read the question carefully, first of all, and then we will check out what we have given. We have given one question where it is mentioned Ashok's mother was three times as old as Ashok 5 years ago. After 5 years, she will be twice as old as Ashok. How old is Ashok today? So basically, in this question, we have to calculate the age of Ashok. So there is a general method where you can assume that the age of Ashok, let's say the present age of Ashok will be X. Correct? This is what you can assume, and this is what we will find it out. Now, according to condition, we are having two people, and it says Ashok's mother was three times as old as Ashok 5 years ago. So if in present Ashok's age is X, you can calculate the age of Ashok 5 years ago. So 5 years ago, age of Ashok will be what? X minus 5. This is the age of Ashok 5 years ago. Now, Ashok's mother is three times as old as Ashok 5 years ago. If 5 years ago, yes, this is the first question, Arish. If 5 years ago, Ashok is X minus 5, age of Ashok's mother, you can calculate here, 5 years ago, the age of Ashok's mother was thrice of Ashok's age, which will be 3 into X minus 5, correct? Now, the condition says after 5 years. So, if you have calculated the present age of Ashok as X, you can also calculate present age of Ashok's mother, as you are saying that 5 years ago, age was 3 into X minus 5. So this time, age will be 3 into X minus 5 plus 5. What happened, Naresh? The topic name is arithmetical reasoning. This is the topic name. And the question, you don't need to understand a conceptual or some tricks, techniques kind of things for this topic. Because every single question which is included in this topic, is that question you have solved various times, many times in your school. All right, the second category is based on BODMAS, for which we are having the questions, given some equations where we have to convert some meaning of the symbols. So that's the second part. We will discuss that portion also. Okay, so right now in today's session, we are discussing the question where we have to calculate the age of any person as mentioned. So if you have calculated Ashok's other in present, Ashok's age in present and Ashok's mother also in present, according to question, it says about after 5 years. So after 5 years, even you can calculate. So after 5 years, this is the general method I'm talking about. After 5 years, the age of Ashok will be what? If present, the age of Ashok is just X. After 5 years, it will be X plus 5. And after 5 years, you can also calculate age of Ashok's mother. Which will be equal to what? If in present, she is 3 into X minus 5 plus 5. So after 5 years, you will add 5 again. This is Ashok's mother's age after 5 years. Condition says that after 5 years, she will be twice of Ashok. Now, right now, Ashok is X plus 5. So, twice of Ashok's age will be 2 into X plus 5. So, this 2 into X plus 5 will be equal to this age, which is 3 into X minus 5 plus 10. Now, you can solve this equation and you will get the value of X. This is one way to solve such kind of question, which many of you have already done various times. Now, can you assume one more thing, student? When you are solving the question and when you are trying to solve the find out the age of Ashok, which you are assuming as X, the answer of this X will be either 10 years or 15 years or 20 years or 25 years. Okay, the X will be either 10, 15, 20 or 25 years. So if suppose in present, if you are thinking that present age of Ashok, let's say is 10 years, let's check out the options and let's consider first two options, 10 and 15. So it says 5 years back. 5 years back, if suppose he is right now of 10, 5 years before, he will be just of 5 years. Okay, if he is right now 15, he will be just of 10 years. Now this time, in this moment, the age of Ashok's mother is thrice of Ashok's age. So if Ashok right now is 5 years back, her mother will be 15. Her mother here will be 30. Correct? After 5 years, what happened? After 5 years, the age of Ashok will be 15. So you can also calculate this age. If 5 years back, she was 15. In present, she will be 20. And after 5 years, she will be 25. Similarly, after 5 years, Ashok will be 20. After 5 years, she will be 35. And she will be 40 after after again 5 years if you compare it from the present age. Now, condition says that after 5 years, the age of mother should be twice of Ashok's age. But 15 into 2 is not equal to 25. So this is not the answer. Whereas 20 multiplied by 2 is 40. So this 15 is satisfying all the condition. So if it's all your choice, if you want to assume as X or if you want to check out with the help of option, that is all always your choice. Right answer will be option B. Is it okay, student? Is it clear to you people? Naresh, yes, your answer is 15, which is obviously correct answer. Is it clear to everybody? Any doubt in this thing? You can solve with the help of equation also, like I have already discussed equation earlier. So let's check out this next question. And let's try to solve this question with the help of equation if you can, with the help of options, if it's all your choices, student. It is saying that a bus leaves Delhi with half the number of women as men. At Meerut, 10 men get down and 5 women get in. Now, these are equal number of men and women. How many passengers boarded the bus initially at Delhi? As you know that the questions are very simple and basic questions from this chapter. So, I think you can try this question and you can share your answers in the comment box. So, let me see what your answer is. Can I have, please? What is the answer, student, according to you? See, we have given a bus leaves with half the number of women as men. Okay? Women are half of men. So if you are considering men as M, women will be half of men, that is M by 2. You have to find out the total number of passengers and total will be men plus women, which will be M plus M by 2. This is your answer. Correct? So, you can solve it like you have given some condition here. It is mentioned that at Meerut 10 men get down. So, you have assumed men as M. If 10 men get down, it will be M minus 10. 5 women get in because women are M by 2. If 5 women get in, it will be M by 2 plus 5. Now, here you are having one equation. You can calculate the value of M as well as M by 2. You will put your values here and you will find out the answer. Otherwise, you can solve it in this way. Can you divide this thing, these, the total number of the passenger can be either 36, maybe 45, maybe 15 or 30. Can you just divide it into two parts where another one is just a double of the first? So yes, we can. It will be 12 and 24 for 36 and 20, for 36, right? That means 24 will be men and 12 will be women. As it says that women are half of men. So if 10 men get down, it will be 24 minus 10, which is 14. And 5 women if get in, it will be 17. And these two values are not at all equal. This is not satisfying the condition. This is wrong. For 45, you can say it is 15 and 30. And then the second part is double of first. Because 10 men get down, so remaining number are 20. 5 women get in, so 15 plus 5 will be 20 again. And now these values are equal. It means this 45 is obviously correct answer. So you can select the answer with the help of options like I have done. Or you can prepare your equation like here I have already. You can calculate M and then M by 2 and that will be your answer. Is it okay? All right, Ekta and Naresh, you both are correct. Will you try this question, student? Please try this. It says, a bus left with some definite number of passengers. At the first stop, half the passenger left the bus and 35 boarded the bus. At the second stop, 1/5 of the passenger left and 40 boarded the bus. Then the bus moved with 80 passengers towards its destination. How many passengers were there originally? Can I have responses? Yes. You are trying with the help of options, student, or solving the question with the help of equation? Options, all right, Ekta, that's really good. Equation, that is all okay, Naresh. Why don't you try it with the help of options, Naresh? It's always very easy. Let me explain you. We have given, we have to find out total number of passengers. According to equation, let's say total number of passengers are x. So what happened at first stop? What we have given? At first stop, half the passenger left the bus. If half left the bus, the remaining number of passenger will be x by 2 and 35 boarded. These are the total number of passengers in the first stop. Then bus moved and at the second stop, 1/5 of this, 1/5 of x by 2 plus 35 left the bus. So that means 4 by 5 are inside the bus. 4 by 5th of x by 2 plus 35. These are the number of passengers inside the bus because 1/5 left. So remaining are inside the bus and 40 boarded plus 40. And now this total is equal to 80. So you are having this equation. Now you can solve it and you can find out the value of x. Otherwise, Naresh, can you please check out this thing? Because it says my answer of x will be either 25, 30, 40 or 50. As it says that at the first stop, half the passenger left the bus. So half of 25 will be what? 12.5. But you know that the number of people cannot be in point, cannot be in such fractions. So yes, it is obviously not our answer. So let's say if it is 30, if half leaving the bus, the remaining number of passenger inside bus will be 15 only. All right. For 40, it will be 20 and for 50, it will be 25. This is what we are having at the first stop. After the half the passengers leave the bus, then it says 35 boarded. If 35 boarded, you will add 35 in all the conditions. So right now you are having total number of passenger as 50. Right now here it is 55, and this is 60. Correct. Now what happened in the second bus? These are the passengers in the first bus. In the second stop, 1/5 leave the bus. So 1/5 of 50 will be 10 only. So 50 minus 10, bus is moving with 40 passenger and 40 also boarded the bus. So it should be equal to 80. Yes, it is matching perfectly and our answer is option B. That's it. Is it okay? I don't need to check out the rest of the options. Is it clear to everyone? So like you are framing x by 2 plus 35, why don't you think that 30, half of 30 will be 15 and 15 plus 35 will be 50? Is it clear? Okay, so here is your next question. I think you don't need equation, even you don't need option for this question number 4. Please read it carefully. A man is 3 years older than his wife and 4 times as old as son. If the son becomes 15 years old after 3 years, what is the present age of wife? Yes, can I have responses, student, for this? Is it 45? Okay. So it was given directly if son becomes 15 year old after 3 years. So if after 3 years, the age of son is 15, present age of son will be what? 15 minus 3, which is 12 years. Correct. Now it is mentioned that man is 3 years older than his wife and 4 times as old as his son. Man is 4 times of his son's age because son is of 12. So 12 into 4. Naresh, how it will be 16? Age of man will be 48 years. But it says that man is 3 years older than his wife. So his wife will be 3 years younger. That means 48 minus 3, 45 years. You have to calculate the present age of wife, not the age of his father. Okay, so answer is 45 years only. Alright, you have directly given a 15-year-old son is after 3 years. So at present, he will be of 12 year only because father is 4 times of his son. So he will be of 48 and is younger and his wife is 3 years younger. So you can subtract and you will get the answer. Can I have the answer for this question now? Question number 5. Can I have a response, student? First line is more than enough, student. You are taking so much time in solving this question. Okay, let me explain you. Father's age is one more time than five times of his son's age. So five times of son's age plus one actually is age of father. This is what you have given and this is what you want to calculate. It means if this is your answer, five times of his son's age plus one, if you are having 30, 40, 31 and 29 as option, and if you subtract one, whatever value you will get, it will be five into son. 5 into son plus 1 is father. So 30 minus 1 will be that value, which is 5 into age of son. So 30 minus 1 will be 29. 40 minus 1 will be 39. 31 minus 1 will be 30. 29 minus 1 will be 28. Do you think that 29, 39 and 28 is 5 times of any value? Not at all. I don't need to calculate anything. My direct answer is 31 years. I really don't need to check out the rest of equations even. Is a clear student, because it says that father is five times of his son's age plus one. So whatever your value is, if you will subtract one, you will get five times of his son. But 29 is not the five times of any perfect value. 39 is not the five times. 28 is not the five times. But 30 is. And that's why the answer is 31 years. Is it clear to you or not? All right, Ekta, your answer is perfect. Why you people are not sharing your answers today? Why not you are participating, although every single question is not new for you. You have solved such category of question various time in your school, isn't it? It's just a question of linear equation in one variable, even if you are trying to solve with the help of considering the value as x. Will you try this and can I have the responses, student, from your side? Read the question carefully first and then try it. There are three baskets of fruits. First basket has twice the number of fruits in the second. Third has 3/4 of the fruit in the first. The average of the fruit in all the basket is 30. What is the number of fruits in the first basket? This is what you have to calculate. The number of fruits in the first basket. So if you are assuming it as x, the number of fruits in the first basket, because that's what you are calculating as x, the number of fruits in the second basket will be what? Because first basket has twice the number of fruit in the second. So if first is twice of second, second will be half of first. So if I have assumed it as x, second will be x by 2. And for third, we have mentioned that it is 3/4 of the fruit in the first. So if it is x, 3/4 of x will be 3/4 of x. Now, the average of these three, if you find the average, that is x plus x by 2 plus 3x by 4 divided by 3 will be 30, or it is 30 into 3. This is what your equation is. Now, you can calculate and you can find the value of x. Otherwise, I am assuming for first basket, either my answer is 20 or 30 or 33 or 40. Right? I am having three basket, first, second and third. As it says that first basket has twice the number of fruit in the second, in reverse I can say that second is just half of first, so it will be 10. If it is 30, it will be 15. If it is 33, fruits cannot be in some point, so this is wrong answer directly. And half of 40 will be 20. So these are the values for second basket and for first basket. Now what is in the third? The third is having 3/4 of the fruit in the first. So 20 into 3/4 will be 15. 15 fruits in the third basket. Now 3/4 of 30 will be something in point, so it cannot be our answer. 3/4 of 40 will be what? Will be 30. If the average, so you have ruled out already B and C, your answer is either 20 or maybe it is 40. You have to check out where the average is 30. It is clearly visible in option D. This is 40, this is 20 and 30. You can settle at 30, 30 and 30. So right answer is 40. All right, Naresh, you have not shared your answer, but yes, Sai Kumar and Ekta, you both are correct student. Right answer is 40. Hope it is clear to everybody. So here is the very next question for you people. Read it carefully and try to mark the correct answer. You have done all these things, student, already in your classes. Already, there is nothing new for you. A father is 3 times as old as his son. 8 years ago, the father was 5 times as old as his son. What is the present age of the son? Okay, student, you are saying option A, which is 12 years, okay? Does it satisfy all the conditions? there is one thing, student, you can consider the present age of son as X. Okay, father is 3 times, so age of father will be 3X. 8 years ago, son will be X minus 8 and father will be 3X minus 8. But 8 years ago, father was 5 times of his son. So 5 into X minus 8 is equal to 3X minus 8. This is your equation. If you want to solve the question with the help of equation, you will get the value of X. Otherwise, if son is 12, father will be 36. If it is 14, then 42. 16, then 48, 20, then 60. Alright. Now, 8 years ago, you can subtract 8 from both the ages. 12 minus 8 will be 4 and 36 minus 8 will be 24, right? So, 4 into 5 is not equal to 24. This cannot be the answer. Similarly, 14 minus 8 will be 6 and the same thing you will repeat. It is not adjusting the equation. This is wrong. Whereas, in this third option, if you can check out, if son is 16, 8 years ago, 16 minus 8 will be 8 only. And if father right now is 48, 48 minus 8 will be 40 only. And we know that 8 into 5 is equal to 40. So it satisfies the condition that father's age is 5 times of son's age. Right answer is option C. Here is the next question. The average age of 25 subordinates in an office is 30 years. If the age of manager is added, the average increases to 31 years. What is the age of manager? Can I have student for this? Age of manager will be 26, no? It cannot be, student. But 56 I can agree. Let me explain in a very simple way. Average means what? What is the meaning of average? You will add all the ages of 25 people, divide it 25, and you will get the average, which is 30. Or I can say sum of age of 25 people will be 30 into 25, which is 750. Right? If you are adding manager, how many people there will be? Already you are having 25 people, one man increases, so it will be 26. So sum of age of 26 people you can find out, because sum of age of 26 people divided by 26 is equal to 31. Or sum of the age of 26 people will be 31 into 26. So this will be equal to 806. All right. Now, because earlier addition was 750, now the addition after adding manager's age is 806. So you can find out the manager's age, which will be 806 minus 750. That is 56 years, option D. Yes, Naresh? 56 is all okay, but you have written means, I mean, if there is any issue, anything doubtful, tell me, is there anything doubtful? Can I give you the next question? Ready? Here it is. Okay, all right. Because I received your response very late, so I thought what you are asking me. It's all okay. Fine. Can you please read the question and can I have the correct answer of this one? Read it carefully. Class A has student twice that of class B. After adding 20 students to class A and 30 students to class B, the total number of students in both the classes is 140. What is the number of students in class A in the beginning? You have to calculate the total number of students in class A in the beginning. Rest of the students, do share your answers. All right, Naresh. So you can directly solve this question with the help of options, student. For class A in the beginning, the student will be either 30, 60, 80 or 140. 140 you can cancel it out directly, because after adding something, the total should be equal to 140. It is saying it is already 140. How it will be 140 only? It will be greater than that. So in class A, either student is 30, 60 or 80. It says that class A has twice that of class B. In reverse, I can say that class B is just half of class A, means will be 15, will be 30, will be 40. Alright? Now after adding 20 to class A, if you add 20 here in class A and 30 in class B, the total should be equal to 140, but this is not equal to 140. So 60 plus 20 is 80 and 30 plus 30 is 60. This total addition is equal to 140, which matches with the condition, and that's why correct answer is option B, which is 60. Otherwise, you can assume that class A is having X, class B will be half, which is X by 2. So you are adding 20 here, you are adding 30 here. Now this total is equal to 140. Then you can solve the equation and you will get the value. Otherwise, it is very simple and easy with the help of options. Here is your next question, and this is really very easy question, student. Just a ratio you have given. Four it is, right? Okay, so ratio is 10 is to 1. Well, even if you are checking out with the help of option or directly, it will be 10x plus x divided by 2 is equal to 22, or 11x is equal to 44, or x will be 4 only. That is option B. Or even you can solve it out directly. If son is 4, father will be 40, and 40 plus 4 will be 44 divided by 2 will be 22. This is not at all matching, that son is 24 and father will be of 240 years. And if son is 40, father will be of 400 years. If son is 14, father will be 140 years, which is just reverse situation, is not balancing the condition. So you can mark the answer. Okay, can I have response for this question, student? You might have solved such question in quants. In a survey of a town, it was found that 65% of the people surveyed watch the news on TV, 40% read a newspaper. Yes, you can use Venn diagram for such category of question, Naresh. Of course, try to convert the data in the form of Venn diagram and you will easily find out your answer. 40% read a newspaper, 25% read newspaper and watch the news on TV. What percent of the people surveyed neither watch the news on TV nor read a newspaper? So, because we are having two things, right? First is those who watch the news on TV and for newspaper, and there is an intersection part also. So, this will be like this only. This is those who watch the news on TV and this is for newspaper. And this is intersection area for both the things. Now, we have given initially 65% watch the news on TV, 65 total. And newspaper reader are 40%. Alright. There is intersection part also, which is 25%. So this 25, this value is included in both the circles. So if I ask you how many people are there who watch news on TV only. So this will be 65 minus 25. That is equal to 40. And how many for only newspaper? It is already 40. 40 minus 25 will be 15 only for only newspaper. Correct. Now you can check out 40 plus 25, total 65, 25 plus 15, total 40 for newspaper. Question is, what percent people neither watch news on TV nor read a newspaper? So let's say total is 100, 100 minus 40, because you cannot include TV who watch news on TV. You cannot include this 25, which is intersection portion of both. Even you cannot include these 15 people who read newspaper. So this is 40 plus 20, 60 plus 10, 70, and this is 80. So 100 minus 80, this will be equal to 20% people who neither watch the news on TV nor read a newspaper. That is option C. So, Manikant, your answer is 15 student. How can if there is any calculation mistake, then please correct it. Or if there is anything else, if there is something problematic that you are not getting, do tell me immediately so that I can make it clear to you. Otherwise, I am going to give you the same category of next question. Is it okay, student? Is it okay? All right, then here it is. All right, Manikant. So here's the next question, student. Try this and try to share accurate answer. All right, student, rest of everybody, you write your answers. Sai Kumar, you are very correct, student, your answer is perfectly okay. So right now we have given the total number of families are 80. It says 20% of these families owned a car each. So car owner are 20% of 80, which will be 16. So 16 families are car owner. Then 50% of the remaining, this is something which is important. You have to understand that it says remaining of 50%. So remaining families will be 80 minus 16, that is 64. 64 are the remaining families. So 50% of 64, which is 32, are those having bike, I mean motorcycle. All right. Now question says, how many families in the extension list that do not have any vehicle, because total are 80. So 80 minus 16 who are car owner plus 32 who are bike owner. If you subtract this value, this is 48. Your answer will be 32 once again, which is option B. Correct, student? Okay, so you have already shared Manikant, Tuhin, Naresh and Sai Kumar. You all are correct, student. Here's the next question for you. Can you please write the correct answer for this next question number 13? Can I have response? Don't take so much time, student. The question is not that difficult. 5. Okay. You can check out your calculation once again if you want. If you want a student, you can check out your calculation once again. See, it is mentioned that 55% owned both car and TV, and there are 70% for car owner and 75% for those who own TV. As there is intersection part, so I'll draw a circle like this. This intersection part denotes 55%, and this circle is for car owner. This is for those having TV. Because total car owner are 70 percentile and total people having TV are 75 percentile. This 55 value is also included in both the parts. So all right, Tuhin, now you have corrected. So 70 minus 55, only car owner are 15 only. And 75 minus 55 will be 20 only. All right. Now you have to find out those who didn't have either car or TV. So 100 minus 15 plus 55 plus 20 it is. So you can check out, this is 15 plus 55, which will be equal to 70 plus 20 is 90, and 100 minus 90 will be 10%, which is option C. 10% of the people do not have either car or TV. All right. Now tell me one thing about this chapter, student. Have you noticed that every single question that is coming in the screen, you are aware of all these kind of categories? There is nothing new. There are two parts from this topic. The very first part is of such kind of question where we have to solve the question, finding, calculating the number of people. Some are based on this Venn diagram. Some are calculating the age of one person. And there is another portion also of this chapter. This chapter is divided into two parts. This was the first part. We call it as arithmetical reasoning. The second is mathematical operators. Okay. So we have already mentioned this thing in your study plan, and the name is mathematical operators. This mathematical operator is also the part of the same topic, which is arithmetical reasoning. But here you have to solve the question which are based on body mass, right? That means sometime you have given one equation, you are changing the symbols, plus will be written as minus, multiply will be written like this, and then you are applying body mass there. So we will check out these kind of questions separately in another session. So I hope you are now okay with such kind of question. Now you will solve the questions with great accuracy level. If there is any problem in any particular question, do tell me, because this is all the category I have covered. It's your time now to attend all the questions given to you people in quizzes and assignments, so that you can check out your accuracy level. Now if there is any issue in any of these 30